presentaciones o algo. Gareth, alguna de esas presentaciones las vamos a tener no solamente grabadas, sino también pueden volver a verlas, visitarlas en el Padlet. Si no están en Padlet, en lo cual también podemos nosotros usar o compartir recursos, entonces vamos a tenerlos también en la grabación. Ok. So, everybody is going to start our class today. But there is one little thing, there is one important thing today, and it is the test. Obviously, what happened to the test? What happened to the test? The problem was that, you know, many people said, what happened to the test? So, I don't know. So, today I am going to check with you the test together. We are going to do some review. Vamos a hacer un pequeño repaso porque algunos creo que se han quedado con la incógnita de qué es lo que pasa con el examen. Okay, I'm going to share here the test, and I'm going to share only part of the screen so that you can see this. Yes, this is the test. This is our test. Okay, good. This is our test. The test had no problem, right? Si no hay ninguna pregunta al respecto en la primera parte, entonces continuamos. No questions, no questions. Advanced, share, yes. Okay, no questions then. No hay preguntas. Okay. So, alguno puso por acá. Good evening, Beth. Good evening, Beth. Esto es un saludo. Es un saludo. Y good night es una despedida. Good night. Good night is saying bye bye. Bye bye. See you tomorrow. Entonces, no puede ser la despedida. Okay, it can't be. No puede ser la despedida. Good evening. Como es un saludo. Hello. How are you, Carlos? That was the correct answer. Good evening, Beth. Hello. How are you, Carlos? Okay, that was the correct answer. Okay, something else was necessary to check here. Well, let's move on. Here you had no problems, no problems with the graphics. Everything was normal. And then you have some other resources here.
Question, teacher.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Teacher, en el que está bajando, en el que está bajando, ahí tengo un problema, ¿no? O sea, me calificó mal y no veo ahí el problema. ¿Me podría explicar, por favor?
Here. ¿En este ejercicio del segundo o en el tercero? Okay, yes, sir. En este caso
En el
nadie
tercero, por
tuvo.
favor, teacher.
En el tercero, perfectamente. Okay, here. Si hay algún error, obviamente lo podemos compensar, podemos corregir. So here, what is the problem here? Here we have David is the first part. David and Monica are social workers, correct? David and Monica are social workers. So that is the form. Or Monica and David are social workers. This is no problem. David and Monica. That is the subject. Es el sujeto. Then comes number two, the verb are. And number three, the profession. Number three, social workers. Trabajadores sociales. Social workers. Como lo han visto en plataforma. Workers social, it's not good. No está bien. Social workers is the profession. Y lo han visto en plataforma. Okay, that is correct. Number two. Now, the first is I am working, present continuous, in Los Yungas. I am working in Los Yungas now. Los adverbios de tiempo, lo que se refiere al tiempo, puede ser al principio de una oración o al final de una oración. So you can say, now I am working in Los Yungas, or I am working in Los Yungas now. Sin embargo, he sido tolerante porque como es algo que les había dicho solo un par de veces en las lecciones, he aceptado que algunos pongan I am now working in Los Yungas or I am working now in Los Yungas. Al medio le pusieron. No problem. Okay. Now, number three. We, that is the first, the capital. Por eso está la mayúscula. We live with my grandmother and my mother. Or we live with my grandmother and my mother. Grandmother and mother were two alternatives. I mean, you could change this. Podían cambiar. Okay? Pero alguno me hizo una oración genial. Me puso, por ejemplo, we and my grandmother live with my mother. Excellent. Si tiene sentido, ¿cómo lo voy a calificar como una oración correcta? No problem. There are varios. Pero si hay alguna duda, me escriben en el chat, en el inbox, en WhatsApp, y vamos a aclarar por qué alguna puede estar incorrecta, alguna otra forma. Number three. Now, number four. Here, the students, podría ser the students or the teacher, como quieran, the teacher or the students, cualquiera, and the students or the teacher, como quieran, the teacher and the students or the students and the teacher are traveling to Tijuana. Otra fórmula no puede haber en ese caso. Pero sí, the teacher and the students or the students and the teacher, no problem. But are traveling to Tijuana. Never are to Tijuana traveling like that. No. The verb, siempre el verbo antes. Okay, the verb is are traveling. Siempre eso va después del sujeto. Are traveling. Después de viajar, ¿a dónde? To Tijuana. That is the adverb of place. Okay, good. Now, number five. It is nice to meet you too. Esto ya era más una frase común y corriente que habíamos aprendido desde el primer día. Okay, if you have any questions, tienen alguna pregunta más, podemos seguir en el otro que es el que más problemas causó a algunos. No problems? Okay, si aún permanecen dudas, no se preocupen, podemos responderlas en el WhatsApp or after the class cuando terminemos la clase. Okay, here we have some problems. Today is Saturday and my family and I are relaxing at home. Esto ya estaba corregido. Okay, so good. My father usually washes his car on weekends. Here we have no problems. No hay ningún problema acá. My father usually washes his car on weekends. But he not washing the car now. Para el presente progresivo siempre tenemos que tener el verbo to be. Entonces aquí debemos poner, but he is not washing the car now. Ahí la oración está correcta. But he is not washing the car now. Now, nuevamente, esta es la referencia que indica que es algo que estamos haciendo en el momento en que estamos hablando. Entonces, ahora, now he is read. Esta oración no existe. He is read. This is not correct. Pero sí podríamos decir, excuse me, sí podríamos decir, He is reading a book. Now he is reading a book about cars. Okay, ahí ya tiene sentido. Aunque pusiéramos he reads acá, he reads, él lee, cuando lee. Podríamos poner en el presente simple, he reads, pero no tendría que ver este now. He reads a book about cars every day, cada día. Por lo cual, es mejor que mantengamos el he he is reading, porque hay esa palabra now, which is at this moment. Okay, he is reading a book about cars. My mother, she always cooks. Aquí es la petición de sujeto. My mother and she. Teníamos que eliminar uno. My mother always cooks. Okay? My mother always cooks. But she not cooking now. Aquí, si fuese presente progresivo, obviamente necesitamos incluir el verbo to be. Por lo tanto, but she is not cooking now. But she is not cooking now. She watching a movie. El mismo caso. She watching a movie. She is watching a movie. She's watching a movie on TV. My sister not doing lo mismo. Falta el verbo to be para que sea presente continuo completo. My sister is not doing her homework. Now, nuevamente, si se refiere a ahora, es presente continuo. Excuse me. Now she paints some pictures. Now, este tenía dos correcciones. She is painting some pictures. She is painting some pictures. My little brother not helping my father. Period. Ahí faltaba nuevamente el is. My little brother is not helping my father. And me? Usually I clean my room. Usually es algo que hoy día vamos a practicar bastante. Usually, usualmente, simple present. Usually I clean my room. Yo limpio mi habitación. No hay nada más que corregir ahí. Okay? Usually I clean my room. No problems here. But I not clean my room now. Otra vez aquí dice ahora. Por lo tanto, aquí tendríamos que poner, but I am not cleaning my room now. Okay? Por este now. At this moment, en este momento, otra vez tenemos las referencias del present continuous. At this moment, excuse me, I'm going to clean this. Okay, at this moment, I tell you, esto está mal. Tendríamos que decir, I am telling you about my family. I am telling you about, ¿por qué? Porque dice, en este momento te estoy hablando de mi familia. I am telling you about my family. How about you? Esto es lo mismo que decir, and you, como les había dicho anteriormente. And you. What are you doing now? Aquí, para que sea present continuous, necesitamos el verbo to be. No hay el verbo to be. Tenemos que aumentarle. What are you doing now? Okay, so with that, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. 11 exercises more. Okay? Si es que acaso tienen una pregunta o algo que no se está entendiendo, con todo gusto nos reunimos nuevamente a solicitud de 1 o 20 nuestros queridos amigos, estudiantes. Podemos reunirnos cuando gusten. Puede ser un día después de esta clase, un miércoles por la noche, un viernes por la noche, y así podríamos despejar otras dudas que no nos alcanza a hacer durante nuestra clase normal. Ok. So, thank you. If you have no more questions, si no tienen ninguna pregunta más, entonces ahí están las respuestas. Ok. Si alguien quiere grabar esto y no preguntarme nuevamente, puede hacer un print screen, una captura de pantalla inmediata en su computadora presionando la tecla Windows y print screen, o sacarle una fotito. Okay, no more questions. Okay, si hay alguna pregunta que no está muy clara, ya les digo, podemos resolverla también al final de la clase o en algún otro momento. No hay nota mínima para considerarse aprobado un examen. Mientras más se acerquen al 100%, mejor. Pero si es que están debajo del 40, entonces significaría que algo está bastante, no está entendido muy bien. Yo pienso que todos tienen un buen nivel. Ningún estudiante ha bajado, creo, del 50%, del 60%. Entonces, no se preocupen por el examen en sí, sino por la producción que ello requiere. ¿Ok? So, don't worry. No se preocupen por la nota, sino por la producción que tenemos que tener al estudiar, al practicar nuestro inglés. Ok, so as for today, what is the thing today? The material for today is very important. First, primero, the first thing that we are going to do is review the numbers. Okay, everybody knows that these are the basic numbers, right? 1 and then 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and then. These are the basic numbers. Everybody read the numbers. No les voy a enseñar los números, pero a ver qué tal si vamos leyéndolos. 1. Okay, let's begin with our first number. Let's begin with this. What number is that? What is that number, please? The first. Okay. What is the first? ¿Cuál es el primero? Everybody?
0.
Okay. Some people say 0. Algunos les gusta decir 0. Pero, ¿alguien ha oído alguna de las películas de James Bond? ¿Ustedes creen que en la película le dicen agente, agent 007? No. Nunca lo han de escuchar así. 007. No hay tal. Okay, so what's the other name for this? Another form of reading the zero number is O. Okay? O. O, como la letra. O. Y es más práctico decir O que decir zero. Porque cuando tenemos una clase, por ejemplo, de cálculo, we don't say 101. Calculus 101. No. We say calculus 101. 101. Y así es que el agente 007 será O07. Pero ni así. Alguien sabe. A ver, ¿quién quiere tener el curso como aprobado? Como aprobado. Yo lo hago aprobar si es que me dice cómo le llaman al agente 007 en las películas. Les doy 10 segundos para que me digan. Porque cualquiera puede buscarlo en el internet.
James Bond.
James Bond. Very good.
07.
Oh, 07. Ah, ok. Se les pasaron los 8, 9, 10 segundos. Ok. What letter is this? ¿Se acuerdan de esta letra ustedes? Letter. This letter. What letter is that?
U.
U. Ok. Excellent. And what letter is this?
W.
Exactly. Very good. De eso se van a acordar para siempre. U, W, 7, double 7, 2, double 2, O, O, 7, double O, O, 7. Double O, 7. Entonces, presten atención a la película, que el gran defecto que tenemos es ver las películas por flojera, de verlas en español, ¿no es cierto? Véanlas en inglés. Empiecen a verlas con subtítulos. Cuando ya hayan visto una película, véanla nuevamente, pero solo una partecita, porque ya la conocen, y solamente véanla en inglés. Ya han de haber leído, ya han de haber entendido. Ese es el desafío que ustedes tienen que proponerse. Y cuando vean alguna película de James Bond, you will see 007, Agent 007. Okay? So, that is the number. Those are the numbers that are important. Consequently, let's practice a little bit more. Here we have the numbers. Okay. A ver, alguno dice 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. No, definitely not. ¿Recuerdan cómo se dice feliz cumpleaños? How do you say feliz cumpleaños?
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday. ¿Eh? Pero algunos dicen happy birthday. Birthday. Happy birthday. ¿Será que lo están cantando a los cumpleañeros feliz cumpleaños o feliz día del pájaro? I don't know. Happy birthday is different from happy birthday. Birthday, el día del pájaro. So, pay attention to these numbers. This is number one. This is number two. Two. Nunca digan two, okay? Two. Number two. Number three. Three. Never three. No, not three. This is a tree. Look, this is a tree.
Yes.
Tree. Árbol. Tree. Okay? So this is three. T-H. Three. Three. Pero tampoco le pongan una F, ¿no? Porque free es libre. Free is libre. So, three, three, and three, three, T-H. Number three, okay? Then number four, four, five, five. The V is clear here. V, five, six, six, okay? Seven, seven. With V, seven, eight, eight, nine, nine. The final N is clear, nine, okay? Please, nine, this N is well pronounced, nine. And then we have number 10, okay? Number 10. 10. Okay, but then we have other numbers. What number is this? 11.
11.
11. 12. 12. 13. 13. Okay, 14. 14, 15, 15, 16, 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20, 20 or 20, okay, 20 or 20. Here we have 20 or 20. Then we have 30, 30 or 30, 30 or 30, 40 or 40, 50, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, and 100. Please be careful because sometimes it is difficult to recreate to pronounce some of the numbers because they might be difficult. This is 13 and this is 30. 14, 40, 15, 50, 16, 60, 17, 70, 1880, 1990, and this is 20 and 100. Please be careful with the pronunciation of the different numbers that we have in most of the cases. So what number is this? 50. What number is this?
17.
17 or 17, right? What number is this?
80.
80. What number is this?
14.
14. 14. Okay, so if you have any little problem with that, so you can change, please, and watch the page that I showed you that you can share. Estoy compartiendo con ustedes una nueva pantalla en la cual ustedes pueden practicar.
659.
Este enlace ya se los he dado, pero es posible que lo vuelvan a necesitar. Me lo piden nomás, ¿ok? So here you have
1969.
Esto les ha de servir mucho para practicar. Ok, so for example, si ustedes le apuntan a uno de los números, les ha de dar la pronunciación.
39, 25.
Ok. 24. Ok, probably you have sound. Sí, tienen sonido.
52.
Y también tienen la escritura.
43. 44. 36.
Ok. Luego tienen un speaking challenge. Cuando presionan speaking challenge, pueden ustedes dictar el número. Si lo dictan bien, les ha de dar el siguiente número. For example, si ustedes encienden aquí arriba, donde pueden ustedes ver un pequeño micrófono, ¿ok? Si ustedes encienden allí, entonces lo van a encender y les va a escuchar. 86.
86.
Lo dije bien, entonces me lo debes repetir. 5.
5.
Y me lo repite. ¿Ok?
1 million.
Ok. Entonces, eso es lo que ustedes pueden hacer. Y reproducir nuevamente si es que quieren. Here.
52.
Ok.
98.
Número 30, 30. Lo que tienen que hacer para articular la TH es sacar aire entre los dientes por la parte posterior y la lengua pegada a ellas. 30. ¿Ok? Como tratando de sacar aire entre los dientes superiores. 30. Ok, una vez que hagan este speaking challenge, también pueden hacer un listening challenge, como pueden ver a la derecha.
83.
Les dice 83. Pueden repetir con este botón que tienen acá. Aquí. Replay. Replay. ¿Ok?
83.
Ok. O pueden, si es que son muy duros para el oído, que les muestre la forma de escribir. 83. Esto es muy bueno para practicar. Okay. 83. Y ustedes tienen que buscar ese 83. Si aciertan,
3.
Les ha de dar por correcto. Inmediatamente lo han dicho y ya les ha dado un número.
3.
Inmediatamente voy a presionar el número en cuestión, les ha de dar la respuesta. Y les salga la siguiente, ¿no? 12.
23. 88. 74.
¿Y si fallo? Ok.
11. 91.
Ok. Entonces, si es que lo necesitan, yo ya les había dado esta página para que, este link, para que puedan practicar ustedes. Esto es para que agudicen el oído y lo hagan cada vez más rápido. Porque si se dan cuenta, marcan rápido, rápido, rápido y pueden ustedes pronunciar bastante rápido y hacer el ejercicio mucho más veloz. Ok, here you are. Next. Now, we are going to keep practicing with another important material. Okay. Okay, a little review on the possessive adjectives. I'm going to share with you. This is very important. Okay, here you are. Cuando hablamos de what's your nationality, what's his nationality, what's your nationality, what's your name, what's his name, resulta que no hemos practicado muy bien y tenemos que ver mucho más esto sobre los posesivos. Okay, so we are going to share something about the possessive adjectives now. These are the possessive adjectives, okay? Here you are. In the chat box I have, thank you, yes. Okay, good. Here you are. The possessive adjectives are these. I have a ball. I have a ball. Okay, I have a ball. Consequently, it's my ball. Sé que para muchos es fácil usar el posesivo y el pronombre. Estamos usando aquí pronombres y sus posesivos, okay? I have a ball. Yo tengo un balón. Ahí está un sujeto, un pronombre, yo, y ahí está el posesivo de este pronombre. De yo sería me, ¿ok? I have a ball and it's my ball. Es mi balón. Ok, now, be careful. I mean, my is plural or singular. Consequently, you can say it's my ball. Or you can say, they are my balls. They are my balls. My does not change. No cambia ese my. My is me, mis. Okay, it could be one object, two objects, many objects, but we don't have the change. I have a ball, it's my ball. I have a house, it's my house. It could be male, female, pues masculino, femenino, plural, singular. So, for example, I have, tengo, ustedes han visto el have en este capítulo, en la plataforma, the verb have. I have a house, casa. I have a house. It's my house. Es mi casa. I have a book. It's my book. Es mi libro. Okay. No problem. Now, I have two houses. They are my houses. Son mis casas. So my plural or singular is the same. Definitely the same. Okay? Good. Now, let's keep on the track. You have a ball. It's your ball. It's your ball. You have a friend. It's your friend. Okay, hello, hello. Melissa, hello. Okay, your friend, your name, your house, your last name, your nickname, possessive for you. He. This is the pronoun, he, él, pronoun he has a ball, okay? It's his ball, and this is the possessive, es su balón, his ball. His is singular and plural also. So his ball, su balón, his balls, sus balones. No problem, there is always one form to understand this. He has a ball. He has a dog. His dog is big. His dog is small, and so forth. Now, what about she? She, for a girl, she has a ball. Lucia has a ball. It's her ball. Her is the possessive for a girl, for she, for women. So we can say instead of she, we can say, for example, Lucy. Lucy has a ball. It's her ball. It's the same. Okay? Now, it has a ball. It has a ball. The dog has a ball. So we say, the dog has a ball. The dog has a ball. And we can also say, it's its ball. It's its ball. Be careful. There is no apostrophe here. Huh? There is no apostrophe. No, it's an apostrophe for Sikas. It's its ball. It's its ball. But usually this word is not frequent. No es muy frecuente que utilicemos este posesivo. Más usamos my, your, his, her, our, nuestro, their, de ellos. But it's not usually. No es tan común. Por lógica, no lo usamos mucho. Okay? Now, we have a ball. You and I. We have a ball. We have a house. We have a class. We have a class. Tenemos una clase. It's our class. Es nuestra clase. It's our ball. It's our class. Nuestro, the same. Our is nuestro, nuestra, nuestros, nuestras. No singular, no plural. Our is only one. Si alguna vez ustedes ven la palabra ours, porque existe evidentemente ours, es que es otra familia de posesivos, que la vamos a ver posteriormente. Okay, so for the moment, it's our ball. Algunos me preguntaron, pero si has visto, teacher, el ours, ¿es porque es plural? No, definitivamente no. Our is nuestro, nuestra, nuestros, nuestras. It could be a lot of objects. It could be one, two, male, female, whatever. You all have a ball. You all have a ball. Todos ustedes tienen una pelota. You all have a ball. Ustedes tienen una pelota. Es su pelota de ustedes. It's your ball. That's your ball. Noten que este your es igualito que el your del singular. Tu balón y vuestro o su balón de ustedes is the same, is exactly the same. It's exactamente el mismo. Okay? Now, they have a ball. Ellos tienen un balón. They have a ball. It's plural, huh? One, two, three people. They have a ball. Consequently, es su balón de ellas, de ellos, right? It's their ball. The possessive is their ball. Es su, de ellos, su balón. It's their ball. Puede ser su singular, puede ser their balls. You can say it's they are their balls. Son sus balones. They are, son sus, de ellos, their balls. Son sus balones. Plural, you know. Well, so it depends on how you arrange the sentence. Okay, now, here we have the form. For I, you have the possessive, my. For you have the possessive.
No.
For you have the possessive, your. Your. For I, you have the possessive, my. Yes. For you have.
No.
The possessive, your. Yes. For he, you have the possessive is. For she, you have the possessive her. For it, you have the possessive it. For we, you have our. Our. Okay? For you, plural, you have the possessive your, plural. For they, you have the possessive their. Okay? So in short, this is what you have to remember. I, my, you, your, he, his, she, her, it, its, we, our, you, your, and they, their. So you can say, what is my name? What is my name? Mi nombre. What is my name? Where is my house? Where is my dad? Where is my father? What time is my class? Okay. What is your name? What time is your class? Where is your house? What is his name? What is his name? What is his name? Where is his house? What time is his class? She. What is her class? When is her class? And so forth. Okay, so you have different possessives here and different forms of using them. This is Bart's dog. This is Bart's dog. Es el perro de Bart. El perro de Bart. It is su perro. How do you say su perro? Yes? My?
No.
No. Her dog?
No.
His.
Correct.
Yes, it's dog. It's Bart's dog. It's his dog. Now, this is Lisa's bike. This is Lisa's bike.
Her.
Yes. It's her bike.
Correct.
Correct. It's her bike. Noten que en un momento tengo que hablarles sobre este tipo de posesivo también, ¿no? Okay. Good. I have a saxophone. I have a saxophone. I have a saxophone. Consequently?
Mine.
Exactly. Very good.
Correct.
It's my saxophone. Dad, you have a donut. You have a donut.
Mine.
It's...
His?
Dad, le está hablando a su papá. Papá, tú tienes una dona. It's
your.
Correct.
It's your donut. It's tu dona. It's your donut.
No.
Okay. Correct. The dog has a bone. The dog has a bone.
It's.
Correct.
It's its bone. Right. Correct. It's. Very good, Angelica. Now, Bart and I have a sister. Bart and I have a sister. Bart y yo. Bart y yo tenemos una hermana. It's.
Our.
Bart and I. It is.
Our.
Yes, Willie. Correct, Willie. It is.
Correct.
Our sister. It's our sister. Okay. So that is a little bit of a review of the possessives. But we have to remember how to use them. Pero tenemos que recordar cuándo usarlos, cómo usarlos. Okay, our. So our class has 25 students today. Our class has 25 students today. Your class is beginners V4. Your class is beginners V4. Okay. Now, who has started platform? ¿Quién ya comenzó plataforma? Si se habrán dado cuenta, en plataforma ya estamos viendo otro tipo de ejercicios, más algo que ya les debo, que ya debemos hacer de anterior capítulo. Okay. First, now I am going to, wait a minute. I'm going to cancel some documents. My goodness. Not now. Very good. Now I have to, it's a little difficult. It is a little difficult. Okay. Tell me, please. I'm going to show you a little video. You will see a little video, okay? Wait a minute. Okay, here I'm going to share my screen with you. Check this, please. Check the video. We use the simple present to describe habits and routine activities. Check this, please.
What do you do after work?
Go home, watch TV.
What do you watch?
I don't know, stuff.
Well, like what?
Like, Ice Road Truckers.
Ice Road Truckers. What happens on that one?
Guys drive on ice.
Ok, now check it again. Vean nuevamente el video y dense cuenta en qué momento qué tipo de verbos usamos. Ok, qué tipo de acciones. Listen with subtitles, please.
What do you do after work?
Go home, watch TV.
What do you watch?
I don't know, stuff.
Well, like what?
Like, Ice Road Truckers.
Ice Road Truckers. What happens on that one?
Guys drive on ice.
Okay, here you have. Look.
What do you do after work?
What do you do after work? What do you do after work? What do you do? ¿Qué haces? What do you do after work? Ya no estamos hablando de qué estás haciendo. We are talking about what do you do? ¿Qué haces después del trabajo? Todos los días en tu rutina. What do you do after work?
Go home, watch TV.
What do you watch?
I don't know, stuff.
Well, like what?
Okay, so what do you do after work?
Go home, watch TV.
Okay, so I go home, watch TV. Imagínense ponerle aquí, I go home, I watch TV. Eso es todo lo que está diciendo. I go home, I watch TV. And then?
What do you watch?
What do you watch? ¿Y qué ves?
I don't know, stuff.
I don't know. Stuff?
Like, Ice Road Truckers.
Ice Road Truckers. What happens on that one?
What happens on that one? What happens on that one? ¿Qué sucede en eso? What happens on that one? Simple present. What happens on that one?
What happens on that one?
Guys drive on ice.
Guys drive on ice. Guys drive on ice. Si sustituimos este guys con I, simplemente la oración cambia de sentido. And we say, for example, guys and I drive on ice. Yo conduzco sobre el hielo. Guys drive on ice. Algunos tipos que manejan sobre hielo. I drive on. That is the simple present. Ese es el simple present que vamos a charlar hoy. Okay. Okay. So what was it? ¿Qué es lo que pasó anteriormente? Que decíamos que teníamos que prepararnos para otro tiempo que les había dicho. Remember? The simple present. Ya habíamos hecho una parte introductoria del simple present y es, ya no es el verbo to be, I am. Ya no es you are. Ahora vamos a encontrar otros verbos. I go, you work, for example. You work. So when we say I go, yo voy, I go to the office every day, es decir, que lo hago cada día. Es una parte de mi rutina. Es mi costumbre, mi hábito. ¿Cuándo usamos el simple present? Para describir hábitos. Recuerden el verbo to be que utilizábamos para algo en general como sentimientos. I am happy. I am sad. ¿Recuerdan que el verbo to be también lo utilizamos para el lugar donde estaba la persona? I am in La Paz. You are in Santa Cruz. You are in Potosí. También hablamos sobre ocupación. I am a teacher. You are a doctor. También hablamos sobre la edad. I am 100. You are 25. Pues el verbo to be era así. Y luego lo hemos adaptado a I am working. Estoy trabajando. I am teaching. Pues ahora vamos a usar otros verbos. Pero otros verbos solitos, sin el verbo to be, sin el concurso del verbo to be. So I go. Fíjense, cuando hablo de un he, que puede ser he o puede ser el nombre, o se, tenemos que hacer lo siguiente. Tenemos que ponerlo en tercera persona. ¿Ok? He goes. Se añade una S. He goes. ¿Ok? You work. You work, you see. You work. Sara, or she, or we can say, for example, Claudia, Dora.
Go.
Dora works. Works. Añadimos la S. Eso es lo que habíamos visto un poquito ya hace unos días. ¿Ok? No utilicemos dos sujetos. He goes is okay. Or Jose goes. But never Jose he goes. ¿Recuerdan que vi un ejemplo en el examen que decía my mother she cooks? No, no. Only my mother or she. Not the two of them. She works here or Dora works. And so forth, we can do several examples. We can check several things like that. Okay? Now, okay, very good. Now I am going to share. Excuse me, yes. He, she, it, se agrega la S. Yes, Marcela, correct. And he, she, it, agregamos la S. Yes. Very good. Can you excuse me, please, for one moment? I have a technical problem. I have to change my mouse. My mouse is out of battery. I have to change mouse. Give me 1 minute, please. Deme un minutito para cambiar mi ratón, okay? Okay, here you are. Thank you very much. And I am really sorry. Sometimes these are surprises. Okay, como dijo, Marcela, en he, she, it, que son las terceras personas, se añade la S. Exactly. So, he, she, and it, you have to put an S here. An S. Okay. No es plural. No es nada, nada que indique ni pluralización, ni apóstrofe, ni lleva un apóstrofe, ni declara posesión, nada. Simplemente se añade la S al verbo en el presente. Okay, so here we are. Now I am going to share another document that we are going to discuss with it. Okay. So, for the routine, we have to check some activities, obviously. What are your routinary activities? What are the actions that you usually do every day? Can you tell me, please, what actions do you do every day? Can you tell me, please, what activities do you do every day? Okay, write in the chat box some verbs in English or in Spanish, if you can't have the vocabulary, but tell me, please, what actions do you do every day? ¿Quién me dice que, cuáles son las acciones que uno hace cada día? For example, in the chat box, I'm going to write, for example, run. Okay, run, brush my teeth, says Jenny. Okay, brush my teeth, yo me cepillo los dientes. What else do you do? Can you tell me what else you do? Wash, alguien lava, wash. Study, very good, study. Son los verbos de rutina, study. Eat, usually work with my computer. Cook, eat. Cooking, no tanto, cook. I work, I go to the office, cook, exactly. Walk, you walk, I walk every day. I walk in the morning, I walk in the afternoon. What else? ¿Alguien se levanta? What, how do you say levantarse? Yes. Get up. How do you say despertarse? Do you know how you say despertarse? Wake up. Breakfast. Alguien dice breakfast. Breakfast is desayuno. So you say eat breakfast or have breakfast. Sleep, very good. Work in the lab. Watch TV. You don't look. Si miráramos al televisor con el verbo look, sería como mirar un objeto inanimado. Pero vemos lo que está pasando en el televisor. So that's watch TV, very good. So we have different routine activities. Here you have some, okay? You are going to check this. Now, look at this, please. Activities.
Wake up. Wash your face.
Les sugeriría que vayamos repitiendo para que sepamos cuál es la pronunciación para recordar también el verbo wash your face, okay? And I'm going to
wash your face,
okay? Wash your face, lavarse la cara.
Wash your face.
Y como está clarito en el video lo que es, no necesitamos traducir para nada. Okay, go.
Take a shower. Brush your teeth. Get dressed. Brush your hair. Do your hair. Do your hair. Make your bed.
Okay, aquí me permito interrumpirles porque decimos make your bed. Obviamente, make your bed. ¿Qué lo vamos a cambiar a make my bed si hacemos una oración para nosotros? I make my bed in the morning. I make my bed. Hago su cama de él. I make his bed. And so forth. Y ahí ustedes ponen el posesivo que se requiera de acuerdo a la necesidad o al ejemplo. Okay, go.
Put on makeup. Have breakfast.
Desayunar.
Go to school.
Drive to work. Drive to work.
Drive.
Work.
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 Study. Study.
Study.
Study.
Wash your hands.
Wash your hands. My hands.
Have lunch.
Have lunch.
Have lunch.
Have lunch.
Leave school. Leave school. Get home.
Get home.
Get home.
Get home. Llegar a casa. Llegar a casa. Get home.
Take a nap. Take a nap.
Take a nap. Take a nap. Take a nap.
Yes, thank
you. Have a snack. Have a snack. Do homework. Do homework. Play computer games. Play computer games. Read a book.
Read
a book.
Read a book.
Read a book. Read a book.
Play with peers. Ride a bike.
Ride a bike.
Ride a bike.
Ride a bike.
Ride.
Ride a bike.
Go shopping.
Go shopping.
Go shopping.
Go shopping.
Go shopping.
Listen to music.
Listen to music.
Listen to music. Exercise.
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 Mop the floor.
Mop the floor. Trapear.
Vacuum. Vacuum.
Vacuum.
Take out the trash. Take out the trash. Water the lawn. Water the lawn.
Regar. Water, regar.
Go for a walk. Go for a walk.
Dar un paseo.
Watch TV. Watch TV.
Watch TV.
Okay, what
do the laundry. Do the laundry.
Hacer el lavado de la ropa. Do the laundry.
Hang the clothes.
Colgar.
Hang the clothes.
Hang the clothes.
Iron the clothes.
Planchar.
Iron the clothes.
Iron the clothes.
Iron.
Do the dishes.
Lavar los platos. Do the dishes.
Do the dusting.
Desempolvar.
Make dinner. Make dinner.
Hacer la cena.
Make dinner.
Have dinner.
Cenar.
Have dinner.
Cenar.
Have dinner. Have dinner.
Take a bath. Take a bath.
Take a bath.
Take a bath. Dry your hair. Dry your hair.
Dry your hair. Dry your hair.
Go to bed. Go to bed.
Acostarse. Go to bed. Acostarse.
Go to bed. Go to bed.
Okay, so here you are. Those are the routinary verbs, the verbs of the routine. So what do? When we describe our routine, we use affirmative sentences, usually in a sequence of elements. Look, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to share with you some connectors that are very important when we tell a story. Sometimes when we tell a story, when we describe a routine, when we describe as a little story about our day, for example, we can say, we can use connectors. Okay, I'm going to write connectors. The connectors are words that are typically used to connect sentences. The most typical ones are and, okay, the word and, the word but, and the word so. Okay, and, but, or so. So if you write a lot of elements in your story to describe your story, I can say, I wake up at 7 o'clock, 7 o'clock, excuse me, at 7 o'clock every morning. I wake up at 7 o'clock every morning, comma, and I have breakfast, for example, okay? I go to school, cool, comma, but, which means pero, but I don't, but I don't take a bus, but I don't take a bus. Okay? I take a taxi. I take a taxi, period. Excuse me, I take a taxi. There you are. Then you can say, for example, I frequently arrive at 8 o'clock, etc. So you can describe your routine like this. I frequently arrive at 8 o'clock, comma, so I have time to meet my friends. My friends. Por lo tanto, tengo tiempo de encontrar a mis amigos, etc. So you see, this is a little description of, let's say, 1 hour in your routine. You can always use these connectors, such as and, e, okay, but, pero, and so, por lo tanto. So these three connectors can make your story more interesting, okay? But because it's not a matter of writing one sentence period, like I wake up at 7 o'clock, period. I go to school, period. Then I take a taxi. No. You can connect the story with these little connectors. Okay. So now what happens? An affirmative sentence in the simple present, an affirmative sentence goes like this. I go to work. I study English. I study English every day. What is the negative? I don't study English. Okay, do you remember? I don't study English. Question, do you study English? Do you study English? Short answers? Yes, I do. Another negative short answer? No, I don't. Okay, so do you remember? ¿Recuerdan qué es lo que habíamos visto anteriormente? So, what is important? That the auxiliaries, and I'm going to write in red, auxiliaries. Do, and, does, are used for questions. Se usa para questions. Are used for negatives. Negatives. And for short answers. Respuestas cortas. Okay. The auxiliaries do and does are used for negatives, for questions, and for short answers. An affirmative sentence, like this one, an affirmative sentence, as you can see here, does not use an auxiliary. Okay, but a negative needs an auxiliary, and the auxiliary is here, you know. I don't study English. I do not study English. The auxiliary is here, do. Do not study English. An auxiliary is also used for questions, as you can see here, for questions. Or better, I say, for questions like this. The question is here, as you can see, do you study English? Do you study English? Question with an auxiliary. And also, we use the short answers with auxiliaries too. Let me change this into red. Okay. Okay. Yes, I do. And no, I don't. You will see here. Yes, I do. And no, I don't. The auxiliaries are necessary most of the time. If you tell a story in an affirmative way, all the story, obviously, you will not need to change into auxiliary use or not. You will have no problems. But if you say a negative sentence, you need an auxiliary. Okay, good. Now, what happens if the sentence is in the third person? Let's say Mary, I'm going to clean into black, okay? Mary work. Mary work in La Paz. Is this correct? Yes or not? No, the sentence is not correct. Terceras personas lleva la S. Mary works in La Paz. Okay, the sentence is good. Negative. She or Mary, it depends on you. She does not work in La Paz. Okay, Mary does not work in Oruro. She does not work in Oruro. Obviously, the negative form, you can reduce it into one form and say, for example, Mary doesn't apostrophe work in Oruro. She doesn't work in Oruro. Now, question, please. What is the question? The auxiliary at the beginning. Does she or does Mary works? Is that correct? No. Ya estamos utilizando el auxiliar, por lo tanto, ya no vamos a utilizar la S. Does Mary work in Oruro? Question. No, comma, she doesn't. She does not. No, she does not. Que lo vamos a contraer? A doesn't. No, she doesn't. Or, yes, she does. Okay, I have something in the chat. Yes, correct. No, she doesn't. And then we say, where? Y si hacemos una pregunta con where, ¿cómo tendría que ser al final? Lo que hacemos es lo que les había dicho, el truco de copiar las cosas. Where, copy, copy, and copy. Where, yes, where does Mary work? Where does Mary work? And the final answer would be, she works, otra vez la S porque estamos en una oración afirmativa, She works in La Paz. Okay. So that is the correct form of the simple present in usage. Okay, now, do you have any questions about this? Obviously, this is theory, esto es teoría. Pero para adelante, yo tengo que preguntarles y decirles, ask me if I live in Miraflores. Okay? I live in Miraflores. I live in Miraflores. Ask me if I live in Miraflores. Pregúnteme si vivo en Miraflores. Yes?
Do you live in Miraflores?
Exactly.
Exactly. The question will be, do you live in Miraflores? Do you live in Miraflores? No, I don't. And what if I say, you ask me, do you live in Miraflores? No, I don't. Where? Where? Consequently, you will adapt. Where do you live? Where do you live? And the question will remain with the same structure. Okay? So, do you have questions about this? Now, where do you live? Exactly. Very good. Very good, Willie. Exactly. Now, that is the topic now. What we are going to do is precisely study what the simple present is. Well, we have a little difficulty because we will need to use the simple present with the time. Vamos a necesitar aprender también la hora. Para eso hemos repasado los números. Pero empecemos con lo que es la estructura del simple present y así no tenemos ninguna complicación. Okay, wait a minute. Now I'm going to share with you my document on this simple present tense. Okay, you describe your daily activities. Do you remember? Yes, ya habíamos visto esto. Get up. Exactly. Get dressed. Now an adverb is get undressed. Brush your teeth. Brush my teeth. Then we have comb your hair or brush my hair, brush your hair. Then we have shave, remember? Shave. Then we have put on makeup, put on my makeup or simply makeup. And then we have eat breakfast or have breakfast. Both forms are correct. Then we have eat lunch or have lunch too is normal. And then in the evening, we have make dinner, have dinner, eat dinner. So, as I told you, the verb, you can use eat breakfast, eat lunch, eat dinner, or you can also use have breakfast, have lunch, or have dinner. This is normal. Okay? You can eat different meals. You can eat, you can have ice cream, etc. Come home, remember? Come home. Now, in the third person, para la tercera persona, no olviden que debemos utilizar esto. Okay? She comes home at 6 o'clock. Llegar a casa. She comes home at 6 o'clock. Okay, this is kind of a review. Take a shower. He takes a shower. Y si le ponemos la hora, ya va a describir algo más. He takes a shower every night, or he takes a shower at 7 o'clock p.m. Or he takes a bath. He takes a bath. He takes a bath every morning, for example. Now, this is watch TV. Watch TV, not look TV. Watch TV. She watches TV. She watches TV in the morning. Go to bed. It goes to bed. It goes to bed. I get up 6 o'clock. I get up at 6 o'clock. She gets up at 6 o'clock. Check the S. Check the S for the third person, please. This is very important. Okay, make dinner. I make dinner every evening. Every evening. This denotes routine. Every evening means that this is a routine reaction. He makes dinner every evening. Don't forget that he is the third person. So don't forget that. Watch TV. I watch TV every day. Me, I watch TV every day. And he watches TV every day. I brush my teeth at 10 p.m. She brushes her teeth at 10 p.m. Notice this. Les dije que íbamos a revisar nuevamente esto. She brushes her teeth at 10 p.m. Third person. Okay. Then, the grammar point for today is that we have this. I, you, he, she, it, and we, you, and they. Notice that these three are called the third person. Ya habíamos visto que anteriormente, ¿por qué les llamamos las terceras personas ellas? So, yes, I is first person. You is second person. He, she, it, third person. We is first person plural. You is second person plural. And they is third person plural. Okay. So, for the grammar point, we have to analyze that or to remember that I and you keep the verb in the simple format. I play, I watch, I study. You play, you watch, you study. And all the verbs in the simple form, please. While in the plural form, they are not different. So we say, we play, we watch, we study. They are similar. Even if it's nosotros estudiamos, there is no change. We study. I study, yo estudio. We study, nosotros estudiamos. In English, there is no difference. But there is a little difference in the third person. Because in the third person, we have to add the S. The S for some verbs, the ES for some other verbs, and the YES for different verbs. In general, we have to add an S. Sometimes we use only the S. Sometimes we use ES. And sometimes from study, you change to IES. Okay. In a moment, we will see when. Okay. The simple present tense of the third person is like this. Generally, when the verb is something like get, make, sing, or play, you add only the S. Noten que en la mayoría de los verbos simplemente añadimos la S. Get, gets. Make, makes. Sing, sings. Play, plays. Okay? But sometimes we have some other spelling rules. When the verb ends in sounds like this, cuando termina en sonidos silbantes, sh, sh, like that, please, you add ES. Añadimos en esos casos ES. Pass, passes. Watch, watches. Okay, pass, passes. Watch, watches. Wash, washes. Fix, fixed. Okay? Then, when the verb ends in Y, cuando el verbo termina en Y, ya saben, ya lo habíamos visto también, fly changes to flies. Look. Okay? Flies, fly, flies, study, studies, try, tries, hurry, hurries, fry, fries. Okay? Usually, there is a rule here. Hay una regla para esto. Si esta Y tiene una... I'm going to change. Sorry. Excuse me, please. I'm going to stop share sound. I can't. Okay. Okay, I muted. I'm sorry. Tuve que silenciar a todo el grupo. Okay, flies. Esto sucede cuando la Y tiene por detrás una consonante. En ese caso, sí se cambia a esto. Porque si no es así, por ejemplo, play, no es consonante detrás de la Y, entonces en ese caso solo se aumenta la S. Okay? Play, plays. En este caso, fly, tiene consonante, flies, studies like that. Okay, that is it then. Okay. Pero hay excepciones, obviamente. Son cuatro. Usually three or four. Do, the third person is does. Go, the third person is goes. Have, the third person is has. Okay. Okay, here you are. Pronunciation. La pronunciación es la siguiente. De las terceras personas hay que tener mucho cuidado de pronunciar no como si fuera simplemente una S. Usualmente pueden haber ciertas pequeñas distinciones. Okay? The pronunciation is S, okay? After get, gets. Take, takes. It, its. Now, what happens with the other? Look at this second part. When we have to pronounce z, como la Z del alfabeto, shaves, comes, needs. Okay? Y a veces pronunciamos la tercera persona, watches, brushes, practices. Okay? There are three types of pronunciation. Son tres tipos de pronunciación. Cuando el sonido es sordo antes de la S, noten el verbo. Piensen en el verbo en su forma básica. En este caso les pido pensar en el verbo get. ¿Ok? Piensen en el verbo en su forma base take. ¿En qué sonido termina? En take. No piensen en la E. Take. It. It. Estos sonidos son llamados sordos. Cuando el sonido sea sordo y le añadimos la tercera persona, o sea plural o cualquier S, su pronunciación ha de ser nuestra S, la del español. Get, gets. Take, takes. It, its. ¿A qué me refiero con sonidos sordos? Son aquellos que se pronuncian, que se articulan así, que no se pueden hacer un sonido largo. Por ejemplo, t, es así, seco. K, k, takes. Y así hay muchos verbos que tienen sonidos sordos. En cambio, si el sonido, si el verbo termina en su forma base en un sonido sonoro, por ejemplo, like that. Okay. Or noten que es sonoro. Y algunos así que son sonoros. La pronunciación de la tercera persona va a ser shaves, z, comes, needs. Okay. Como si fuera una z. Y para los que ya habíamos dicho, sonidos que silban. Ch, sh, a esos vamos a añadir una ES hasta en la pronunciación. Watches, brushes, practices. Noten, practice, bueno, no voy a escribir todo esto acá. Practice, terminan ese sonido silbante. Sería difícil utilizar este sonido. practices imposible. Tampoco podría decir practices. No, por lo tanto tengo que añadir un sonido extra más. Practices. Brush. Termina en sh. Brush. The third person will be brushes. Watch. Watch. Watches. Ok. No es tan importante, pero van a notar que cuando un nativo habla, casi sin, obviamente sin pensarlo, ha de articular estos sonidos de esa manera. Ok. The time. The time. Para nuestra siguiente clase tenemos que definitivamente volver a tratar este asunto del tiempo porque no nos dio ahora más tiempo para hacerlo. Ok. Very good. So, look at this, 7 a.m. I wake up at 7 a.m. in the morning. I wake up at 7 in the morning. Here you have the verb in the simple form. I wake up at 7 in the morning. La rutina. Routine. I wake up at 7 in the morning. I eat breakfast at 7:30. I eat breakfast at 7:30. Y así, de esa misma manera, todos ustedes pueden describir la rutina. I eat breakfast at 7:30. I go to work at 8 o'clock. I go to work at 8 o'clock. I arrive home at 6 p.m. I arrive home at 6 p.m. I cook dinner at 6:30 in the evening. I cook dinner at 6:30 in the evening. I watch TV at 7:30. I watch TV at 7:30. Okay. I take a shower at 8 p.m. I take a shower at 8 p.m. Obviamente no se queden ahí, no nos quedemos ahí, ¿no? Pueden ya ustedes en su mente hacer preguntas. Do you take a shower at 8 p.m.? Do you take a shower at 8 p.m.? Y los que ya estén avanzados, hacer la pregunta en tercera persona. Does he take a shower at 8 p.m.? Does my mother take a shower at 8 p.m.? Okay, good. I go to bed at 11. I go to bed at 11. Do you go to bed at 11? Does he go to bed at 11? He doesn't go to bed at 11. Okay. So there you are. Now, do you have any questions? Okay, very good. Okay, now there is something I need to tell you. Para la siguiente clase vamos a tener que hacer algunos grupos. This exercise is going to be like a game. Están en una plataforma de juegos. The platform game's name is Quizzes. Okay, so I am going to write in the chat box. Please check the chat box. In the chat box, I am going to write the instructions. Okay. Les voy a enviar en el chat box lo que tienen que escribir en su buscador. Okay, joinmyquiz.com. Joinmyquiz.com. Los que están con computadora, hagan a un ladito la página de Zoom y pueden abrir al mismo tiempo. Los que están solamente con celular, anoten lo que tienen que escribir. Joinmyquiz.com en su buscador. Ok, el buscador, una vez que esté abierto, les ha de pedir un código. El código es el siguiente, yo se los voy a enviar enseguida. Ok. Excuse me, 834-406. Ok, 834-406. Ok, cuando les pide el código, escriban esto. Ok. Y los ha de tener en espera. es un juego del simple present que los va a detener en espera. Si nos va bien en esto, vamos a seguir haciendo algunas otras actividades parecidas para que podamos interactuar de otras maneras también. ¿Ok? 834406. ¿Ok? ¿Alguien lo consiguió? Ok, ya estoy viendo que han ingresado algunos. Ok, Alan ya ingresó. Traten de ingresar. Ok, los que ya se puedan salir, como ya he llamado lista, pueden salirse de la sesión Zoom e ingresar a este joinmyquiz.com y me dan sus comentarios en la siguiente clase. Ok, for the moment, I'm going to say bye bye. Bye everybody, los que no puedan ingresar al mismo tiempo, yo voy a estar de todas maneras con el juego y con ustedes, ¿no? Okay, les voy a dar unos 30 segundos más para que puedan ingresar y al mismo tiempo que estar con ustedes voy a estar en el juego. Ok, sí, esperen nomás, yo les tengo que dar paso para ingresar, enseguida lo ingreso, empiezo mejor dicho el juego. Ok, ha de ser un juego en concurso. Ok. Raquel, ¿tu pregunta? Ok, está muy bien. Ya están ingresando todos. Están en espera.
Teacher.
Yes.
Teacher, dice ahí, ¿cómo está usando Kisses? ¿En la escuela, en una empresa o uso personal?
Uso personal, póngale, si es que les pide alguna cosa así.
Ya, gracias.
Ok. 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 Listo, ya esperé. Entonces, los que puedan seguir conmigo, los que ya están con celular, pueden seguir adelante. Ok, let's go. Mientras tanto, los que me sigan escuchando tienen un tiempo límite de 30 segundos para hacer cada ejercicio.
Una consulta, teacher.
Yes, Eric.
¿Alguno de los juegos?
Ya inicié esto. No sé si has ingresado, yo ya lo he iniciado. Tú puedes, no sé si puedes ingresar ya.
Me sale tabla multiplicar, jugando con los números enteros.
Ah, ok. Entonces, en el código que te pide al ingresar, tienes que poner el número que te dicté.
Sí, introduce ese código.
Ajá. Sí, tal vez algo ingresó mal, porque es el, por si acaso, es el 834406. Todos ya están prácticamente avanzando, te cuento. Tengo a 9 participantes en este momento que están dentro del juego.
Teacher, me pide cuenta.
Cuenta. Si es que te pide cuenta, puedes ingresarte con tu cuenta Google. Si es que te pide, no debería pedirte, debería ser directo. Es que a veces los mismos equipos nos frenan. Por eso es que quiero probar si es que se puede hacer todo el tiempo esas actividades.
Excuse me, teacher. Yo he entrado al juego My House. Uh-huh. Entonces, quiero seleccionar alguno de estos, de esas respuestas, si no me permite. ¿Qué es lo que tengo que hacer?
¿Tú tienes alguna que no te permite continuar?
O sea, he entrado al juego My House, está debajo de matemáticas.
Ah, no, no es ese. No es ese nuestro juego. Yes.
Teacher, finish the game.
You finish the game? Very good. Very good. Excellent.
Choose the color. He don't like it. He love.
Wait a minute, please. Wait 1 minute. As you can see, you can see, pueden ver en pantalla lo que está sucediendo con los que están en medio del juego.
Ay, no, ¿dónde está?
Teacher. Para ingresar, yes, dos veces pide el código, por eso otros no pueden ingresar. Uno al ingresar, otro después de que hayamos puesto la cuenta Gmail y vuelve a pedir el código y recién entraba al juego.
Ok, pero ¿lograste entrar?
Sí, teacher, el mío está como Katy Katy en vez de Catherine Molinedo.
Ok.
Cambié el nombre de mi Gmail.
No problem, no problem. Very thank good. You. No problem. Okay. Okay, very good. Bueno. Okay, para todos los que pueden escucharme. Okay, thank you very much. Es una manera también de continuar practicando. Vamos a, si es que nos sale bien, vamos a utilizar un par de plataformas más que se hacen independientemente o podemos usarlas todos juntos. Okay, por ejemplo, en el caso de Padlet, podríamos todos, si se inscriben como usuarios de Padlet, podríamos todos escribir al mismo tiempo en Padlet con algunas indicaciones, respuestas, preguntas. Esto a fin de hacer que nuestra clase no esté centralizada en una pizarra ni en solo una presentación. Okay. Well, that is all. Thank you.